In this episode, we're going to be talking about what is artificial intelligence, and then we'll dive a little deeper into what is machine learning, what is deep learning, what about generative AI, or things like large language models. Let's cover it all. Welcome to Control-Alt-AI, the show about everything AI, from what is it to how do I add it to my app. First, why do we call it artificial intelligence? Well, let's start with what we consider natural intelligence, like our own brains. Hopefully we have intelligence there. And anything we do to try and replicate that natural intelligence is artificial in nature or man-made. Think about our natural intelligence. As we grow, we learn. And as we learn, we begin to be able to infer and reason results based on incomplete information. For instance, think about the way our natural intelligence works. When we see a pattern like this, with a square and then a circle, then a square, we can infer that the circle would come next in that sequence. Likewise, artificial intelligence is learning how to learn, infer, and reason equally, if not better, than our natural intelligence. You've probably seen AI in pop culture a lot, with Skynet and Terminator, or HAL in 2001. But in most instances, we're not to that level yet. But why, Michael? We've seen those movies, and they do not go well for us. Why would we want to replicate that? Well, we're not trying to replicate that, but there are a lot of use cases where AI can really help us. In fact, you're probably already using AI today. Do you use like a Face ID to open your phone? Or you get recommendations on YouTube or Netflix? Heck, in the healthcare industry, AI is already helping doctors and radiologists detect cancer faster than ever. So let's dive in a little deeper and talk about how AI works. Within the sphere of artificial intelligence is machine learning, and it's exactly what its name implies. It's machine learning things that we didn't specifically program into it. We send lots and lots and lots of data to it, and it begins to learn and then infer and reason on its own. Let's step back to our natural intelligence again. In our pattern matching, when it was a square, then a circle, then a square, it's really good, if not better than humans, at recognizing patterns in vast amounts of data. And it's also good at recognizing outliers to those. So if we expounded on that pattern with a square, circle, square, circle, our brains register, hey, wait, one of these things is not like the other. So does machine learning, only it's able to do it at a vastly larger scale than we can. If we dig even deeper into machine learning, we get to deep learning. And we can't really talk about deep learning without discussing neural networks. Now, we're going to step back to our natural intelligence again. If we think about our brain, it's made up of these neural pathways and nodes that are firing to help us reason, infer, and learn, right? In the same way, we're building neural networks that mimic that behavior that help the machine reason, learn, and infer. Now, deep learning gets its name because it is multiple neural networks stacked to help the application think. Now, when we talk about mimicking the way our brains work, it's important to notice how all of our brains work differently. For instance, if we listen to this song, some of you are about to start singing Under Pressure by Freddie Mercury and David Bowie. Others are going to start singing Ice Ice Baby by Vanilla Ice. Some of you have never heard that song, either one of them, before, so you don't really have context for what comes next. In the same way, our brains process that information differently. In another example, let's think about the question, what time is it? Now, if I present that question to you, you might respond with, it's 15 till 4, or it's 3:45, or it's a quarter till 4, or almost 4. And we don't really know why you chose to say each one in each instance. Similarly, we don't really understand why machine learning says the answers that it's giving. And if we ask it a question 10 times, it may give us similar, but likely different answers to each question. But it does form our next level of AI, foundation models. And foundation models may be the first term you're not really familiar with. Foundation models are deep learning neural network models that have been trained on huge, huge amounts of data. Now, data scientists will use those foundation models as the foundation to build other models rather than building them from scratch. And though you may not have heard the term foundation model, you've likely heard of examples of those. For instance, if you've heard of GPT-4, BERT, Stable Diffusion, These are all foundation models that have been trained on large amounts of data and that data scientists can use and then build upon. Foundation models are a form of generative AI, or genAI. They can generate output based on one or more inputs. These models are grouped into different segments depending on what kind of data they were trained on. For instance, GPT is a large language model that was trained on vast amounts of data. It's a large language model, and its sole purpose is to learn to predict when I ask this question, what is the word, sentence, paragraph, or even document that I would expect to come next as a response to that question. If you've used tools like Copilot or ChatGPT, or perhaps you've talked to a chatbot with a support question, those are all built on large language models, and they're trained so that they can respond to your questions, or as we call them, prompts. Other models are trained on lots of audio or video so that they can generate new audio and video. Or perhaps they're used to transcribe or even translate spoken words into written text. Now here on YouTube, you're experiencing AI without even realizing it. For instance, I'm going to say some words in a moment that are going to make your browser animate. So be sure to watch all the buttons below to see what happens. And if I say something like, hey, if you enjoy AI content and learning about it and want to see more, be sure to hit that subscribe button below. Notice that animation that went off. Now, if I were to say, if you enjoyed this video and got something out of it, I would really appreciate if you would smash that like button. Notice what happened there. That's pretty cool. It's a model trained on audio, listening to what I say, and based on that, animating those buttons at the appropriate time. Pretty cool, right? Now, we've just covered the basics of artificial intelligence with machine learning and deep learning, generative AI, LLMs. Listen, we're going to get into a lot more, but if you have questions like, well, how are models trained? How do you know it's answering correctly? We're going to cover all that in future episodes, so do be sure to subscribe to get more. If you've got a question that we didn't cover, be sure to leave it in the comments, and we will get to it, I promise you. Until next time.